هيا على الفلاح.
We gave Luqman wisdom. And what did we do when we gave him the wisdom? It was in order for him to be grateful to Allah, to be thankful to Allah. When you have been given a gift from Allah, you need to be thankful. If you show ingratitude, Allah will punish you, or Allah will take it away. Allah will take it away. And this is why when you have goodness, when you have the deen, when you have been blessed with iman, remember you need to cherish it. You need to value it. Because Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ أَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَاءُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ. O people, you are the ones who are in need of Allah. Allah does not need you, but you need Him. Allah is independent. Allah is all-able, all-powerful. It is you who needs Allah. He continues the very next verse after that. He says, إِن يَشَأْ يُذْهِبْكُمْ وَيَأْتِ بِخَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ. If He wants, He can eradicate you, He can delete you, He can cause you to die, and He can replace you with another creation. He will replace you if He wants. And that's not difficult for Allah. That's what He says. So if we don't want to be replaced, we need to appreciate the gifts of Allah upon us. We need to worship Allah. We need to be behaving ourselves. We need to be people who are beneficial on earth. Understand why you are on earth. You are on earth in order to worship the one who made you during the short test period, which lasts approximately 70 years. That's why you are on earth. You are on earth to worship Him, and at the same time, if you want to worship Him, you need to acknowledge that He is the creator of everything around you. So you need to respect the rest of His creation. Allah made everything around us. You respect creation. You do not harm people. You do not harm animals. You do not harm birds. You do not destroy the environment or the ecosystem. Subhanallah. Causing unnecessary headache and pollution or destruction is against the very reason that you have been sent onto earth. Remember this. So you thank Allah, Allah will give you. If you don't thank Him, He takes it away from you. And sometimes He may even punish you as a result. May Allah not do that to us. Say Ameen. My brothers and sisters, this man Luqman was so beautiful, so wise. He related the gift that Allah gave him to Allah. When he was wise, did he say, I am wise because I have a lot of experience, because I have a top brain, because my IQ is very, very high? No, he related it to Allah. There is another example in the Quran. At the time of the Prophet Moses, may peace be upon him, there was a man known as Qarun. Allah says, we gave him also, we gave him a lot, we gave him wealth. إِنَّ قَارُونَ كَانَ مِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَى فَبَغَى عَلَيْهِمْ وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ مَا إِنَّ مَفَاتِحَهُ لَتَنُوءُ بِالْعُصْبَةِ أُولِي الْقُوَّةِ إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ قَوْمُهُ لَا تَفْرَحْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَرِحِينَ. Allah says, indeed, Qarun was from the nation of Moses, may peace be upon him. But he reneged from them. He transgressed. He went beyond the limits. What did he do? Allah says, we gave him treasures, so much wealth that wealth itself was packed into huge treasures. And the keys, just the keys to his treasures, They were so many and so heavy that it was difficult for a group of very strong men to carry the keys only. That's what the Quran says. Imagine what type of wealth he must have had. What treasures he must have had. The keys are so heavy. Today, even if you own $10,000, to be honest, it's one small pile like this you carry out in your pocket and you can move. Right? Allah says, we gave him a lot. What was his crime? You know what his crime was? He removed Allah from the equation and he said, I got all of this because of my brain. I got all of this because I outsmart everyone. I am a top brain. I'm very witty. I'm a shrewd businessman, etc., etc. And he took Allah out of the equation. So Allah says, the crime was he related what we blessed him with to himself, not realizing if he says he used his brain to get what he got, who gave him the brain? How many people don't have a brain? How many people, when I say don't have a brain, I mean they are struggling and suffering. When it comes to mental health, may Allah give them cure. Say Ameen. And may Allah grant cure to all those who are sick and ill in any way throughout the globe. Say Ameen. My brothers and sisters, Allah gave you the brain. Allah gave you the hands. Allah gave you the eyes. Allah gave you the nose. Allah gave you the tongue. Allah gave you the lips and the teeth. Allah gave you the movement. If Allah wants, wallahi, no matter how powerful you are, no matter how strong you are, no matter how much you have been exercising on a daily basis and going to the gym and doing whatever else, if Allah wants, one small nerve in your system can move out of place and cause paralysis and you will not be able to move and you won't know what is wrong with yourself. That is Allah. That is the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So thank Allah that He has given you your eyes and your nose and your ears and your lips and every faculty that you have. Thank Him and you have a brain and a mind and you have legs to walk. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless those who are immobile and grant them cure. Say Ameen. So my brothers and sisters, we need to relate everything we have to Allah. Today if you have wealth, yes, you might have used the brain that Allah gave you. You see how you relate it to Allah? That is called gratitude. It's called acknowledging. Someone taught you when you are young, as you grow older, you begin to go against themselves, not realizing that's my teacher, that's my ustad. Let me respect this particular teacher of mine at least. Subhanallah, they did good to me. So Allah says, هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. Is the recompense of goodness anything besides goodness? Which is it of the favors of your Lord do you deny, O mankind, O jinnkind? Remember my brothers and sisters, when someone does good, you do good back to them. But a better person is he who does good without someone doing good. Don't wait for someone to do good to you and say, they gave me something, I give them something. Do good before they have even done good to you. Look at Allah. Before we even worship Him, He already created us. We didn't even understand because our minds were not developed when we were in the wombs of our mothers. But we were born and we grew older and older. And then He says at the age of puberty, it is now your duty. You are known as mukallaf. Mukallaf meaning you are responsible to worship Allah, to look for Him, to search for Him, to ask questions no matter what they are, until you find your Maker and you only worship your Maker, none else. Whoever made me, I owe my worship to Him. Whoever created me, I owe my worship to Him. Whoever I'm going to return to when I die, I put my head on the ground and I said, oh you whom I'm going to return to when I die, have mercy upon me. That is called Islam. Subhanallah. So if you are thankful to Allah, Allah will give you in return. If you show goodness, you will have goodness. If you give goodness, you will have it. And when someone does good, you expect from them also that subhanallah, that goodness be acknowledged. They've done it, you recompense. When you do it, you expect that. The minimum is you are not harmed. You know, there was a time, a long time back, when mashallah, our friends were those who used to help us. Now, the world has become so material. When I say material, everything is about money. If I'm getting something from you, I'm your friend. If I'm not getting something from you, I don't need to even greet you. You know, we are taught if you want to spread love, you must greet. Salam. In Sierra Leone, they told me when I entered, first time in my life, I learned about this beautiful culture. They said, you have to put your window down and you have to wave at those who are there to greet you. I was surprised. To me, it's something new and different because normally we don't want to be arrogant or to show that, you know, I'm some big person, etc. No, we are nothing in the eyes of Allah. We are all equal. We are all the same. Maybe I'm worse than you. Who knows? May Allah forgive me and forgive you and grant us Jannah. Say Ameen.
Ameen.
So, as I waved at a few people, I noticed how happy the people were. They were so happy and delighted. Subhanallah. I learned something. And I told myself, Subhanallah, look at how appreciative the people are. Subhanallah. So I'm standing here in front of you, mashallah, tabarakallah. And I ask you to forgive my shortcomings. If I have said anything or if I have erred in a way that you might have felt hurt, forgive me. Because when you forgive, you achieve the forgiveness of Allah.